Hey guys, welcome back to Colline alle Montagne, where I, Evelyn, help you navigate the wonderful world of Italian bureaucracy with lots of help from wine. So today I am drinking a Barbera d'Alba Superiore from Franconi. It is my absolute favorite Barbera in all of Piemonte. So go get yourself a bottle and settle in because today we're going to be talking about the tessera sanitaria and your healthcare in Italy. What is the tessera sanitaria? It is this little guy, okay? It is a blue little card. Now, sometimes they give you actually a paper version, and then when you get to be a resident and you're really fancy and they love you, they'll give you a nice plastic identification card. So the tessera sanitaria is essentially the coverage that you are signed up for the Italian health system. Now, personally, I waited way too long to sign up for this wonderful Living in Italy perk. Guys, it is free healthcare. You want to sign up for it as soon as possible. You can sign up for it actually as a student under the student visa, and we'll get to that in a second. But first, let's talk a little bit more about Italian healthcare and what it means. So if you are signed up for the tessera sanitaria and you have the actual Italian healthcare, you get a free doctor who you can contact and get free appointments with. And with this doctor, you can get your prescriptions, you can get blood work done. And some of these things you do have to pay a tiny fee, but it's really nowhere near paying the whole thing. Being signed up to the healthcare also means that emergency services are free. It also means that if you need to see a specialist because you have a condition, for example, I needed to see a neurologist for my migraines. I got on the waiting list in order to get a free one. In the end, I chose to go for a private doctor, but this is why. First, so that is the public system. You do get a lot of free benefits. It is really great. Another great free benefit is that for all the women in Italy, if you are signed up for the healthcare service, you will get a message every few years that you get a free pap smear and HPV test. Also, if you reach a certain age, there is a free mammogram and they set up the appointment for you and they send you reminders to make sure that you are getting checked. And this honestly is something that I really love about the system and think that they do really good to take care of. However, I want to talk to you a little bit about the difference of private and public. So the public healthcare system is great because there is a lot that is covered for free. However, free does not always mean necessarily that you get the greatest quality in terms of customer service, and also that you might be waiting a very, 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 very long time. For instance, I got for free on the list to get a root canal. It was gonna take a year and a half. Didn't really have that time. So I choose to go to a private. Private doctors can cost a varied amount. It depends who you go to and for what. For instance, I've kind of seen that a lot of times in Rome, I got for the general running, a gynecologist was 180 euros. Others might be different prices, but if you also are lucky enough to live in Bologna or Milan, you should check out the Centro Sant'Agostino. They have a wonderful service where specialists only cost 60 euros and then quick checkups even cost less. That is definitely a great service that I definitely recommend taking advantage of. If you are in other parts and you really want an English speaking doctor, you can take a look at their prices and find a doctor on the website doctorsinitaly.com. I have included it down below for you guys to check out. Now, prices can totally range for private doctors, but yes, you will need to pay something. The amount that you have to pay for these doctors is way, 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 way less than you could ever imagine maybe in the US, but it is still something you have to pay out of pocket. So it kind of depends on you, your own budget, what you're planning for. So how exactly do you go about getting this wonderful tessera sanitaria? There are two different processes. It depends if you are a resident in Italy or not. First, let's talk about if you are a resident like me. If you are a resident, what happens is that when you go and apply for your residency in your comune, in your town hall, they're gonna give you a nice little piece of paper that basically just states, hey, you are a resident, like, cool. And with this piece of paper, they'll tell you this you bring to the ASL. This is your azienda sanitaria locale. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna take this little piece of paper, take your ID card, head on down to the local ASL. Each town kind of has different. They're not divided necessarily by specific town, but usually a group of towns. You're gonna have to look who is your closest. Head on down there, head to the office, walk on in, say, hey, I got this card, I'm a resident, I need a doctor. Cool. So they will then register you as a resident and they will look for how to find your new doctor. Most of the time you can just walk up onto the offices and say, hey, I need some help. But since these times have kind of changed in the last few years, you might also need to contact them via phone or email to set up an appointment to do this. It depends on their restrictions. Now, when you get there, what you're going to ask is, devo scegliere un medico di base. This means I need to choose my general practitioner. And they're going to help you find the correct office. You're going to go there with your paper and it's all going to be set. Along with this piece of paper that the comune has given you, you should always bring with you your passport and your permesso di soggiorno or carta d'identità, any ID you have. Bring them all, bring everything just in case, because, you know, with Italy you need 10 million copies, and make sure that you're always prepared. Even over prepared is better. Now, you may or may not have to pay on spot for your health insurance. For example, when I was under an unemployed or student permesso di soggiorno, but I had residency, I had to pay because technically I wasn't paying the taxes to cover the health insurance. So I had to pay 149 euros per calendar year. So it starts January to December. Now, that price is subject to change, so I can't promise you that that's what it costs now, but just a fair warning that you will have to pay something per calendar year. Instead, if you are working in Italy and paying taxes and, you know, as a freelancer or something like this, then it will be included and you don't need to pay separate for your tessera sanitaria. Then once you have this and you're signed up, what you can then do is choose your doctor, and they will give you a list of doctors that are available in the area. You can look at their address of their offices, their hours that they are available, and their phone numbers. I don't really have any advice for you. It really depends on what you want for a doctor, but I usually try to choose the doctor with the most available hours, an address that's close to my house, and I really like it if they include a cell phone number so that I can know that I can definitely get a hold of them. But other than this, they won't give you a lot of information about the doctors, but you can do a quick Google search if you want and find out more, and then choose your doctor. Now, what to do if you are not yet a resident in Italy? First, you drink wine. So what to do if you are not a resident yet in Italy? You can still voluntarily sign up for the healthcare. So what you're going to need to do is bring your permesso di soggiorno or your receipt that it's being renewed, your passport, your codice fiscale, and a certification that states where you live. Most likely this will be a rental contract if you have it. Bring all this down to the ASL and they're going to have you fill out a form that is iscrizione volontario. This means voluntarily sign up. There will be a specific cost you'll need to pay for the calendar year, and the form might be a little different region to region as well as the price, so I can't give you exactly the specifics because it all depends. But then once you have that and you've paid directly to them, you are all set and you have a year worth of healthcare with Italy. You will need to go back to the ASL if you want to renew this for the next calendar year. Be sure to remember that is calendar year, January, December, not year from where you signed up, all right? So that is what you need to know about your ASL, about your wonderful Tessera Sanitaria, and I'll see you guys later.